Kotal, but only a man of courage, one who will shed blood, will pass. Self-sacrifice is the noblest quality of humanity. You may go. Beware the monster in the water. You may have my knife to defend yourself.
Weird.
You pick up the beautifully crafted knife.
All right. Okay, let's go. Let's continue.
You are in a dark forest. You can hear the flow of water to the northwest.
Northwest, yeah, there.
Familiar glowing spheres light the path.
Okay then, let's go. Holy crap, it's a monster.
The river water is too muddy to get an idea of its depth, or what may be beneath its surface.
Just look at it, I mean, holy crap.
Mr. Spock is looking ahead to a cave opening on the other side of the log. Lieutenant Strage is looking at the big creature in the water. Captain Kirk is looking at the big creature in the water. The river water is too muddy to get an idea.
Yeah, okay.
The river water is too much. Luminescent insects swim. This plant has a rather thick stem and prickly leaves.
So a plant, eh? Okay, let's try and take it.
It would appear that the plant secretes a chemical that is a natural repellent to the creature. It has retreated far downstream, Captain.
Wow, what incredible luck! Oh, well, that's... yeah. Crossing the log. Nothing much.
Darkness leading into the unknown. They appear to be ordinary rocks. Spock's tricorder might say otherwise.
That's very good. Yeah, that's tricorder then.
Fascinating. These rocks are limestone, but contain an unusually high content of heavy metals. There are dilithium crystals here, but in a very raw form.
It is a large cluster of crystals.
Alright, let's just analyze it real quick.
This appears to be a formation of raw dilithium crystals, Captain.
Ooh, dilithium. Just great. It's the substance that powers the ship engines, if you're not familiar with Star Trek lore.
You have one dilithium crystal in raw form.
Alright. Now it's time to set at the on the black market. Yeah.
I watched as you worked through the problems I set in your path. You are a valiant, intelligent species. Please sit down. We have much to discuss.
I've had it up to here, with so-called superior beings terrorizing my crew because we're so primitive. Maybe you should see how primitive you are before you go around testing others. One thing first, if you're so peaceful, how come the Aztecs were so violent and aggressive? Yes, I guess we do. Go on. I've had it up. Yes, I guess we do. Go on. One thing first.
I tried to teach them the concept of self-sacrifice. It would appear they did not completely understand my teachings.
Oh no?
You are clearly not the liars I thought you to be. Were you telling me the truth about my disciples? That they became ruthless savages?
The Federation is not in the business of lying, mister. Absolutely. Your best intentions were changed by the imperfect humans that you left in charge after you departed. Such is the way of our race, I'm afraid.
Yeah, that sounds about right, Kirkus.
You messed up in a big way. Perhaps you should try following the Prime Directive. It changed our lives.
Meh.
Absolutely.
I sense truth in this. Perhaps this is what happened to my children on the Klingon world of Rakur, which would explain why they are searching for me. I have clearly abused the power that was given me long ago.
You show great wisdom, sir, but your statement implies that you wish to change your condition.
Indeed. If my mission of peace was overthrown, then I am no longer worthy of my power. Tell me, has your species made progress in the medical arts?
We're a technologically advanced starfaring race. What do you think? That we wouldn't have made progress in medicine? With Dr. McCoy, I sometimes wonder, but yes, I would say we have made considerable advances. Yes, why do you ask? With Dr. McCoy...
Then I shall ask to make use of your advances. At the top of my spine is a gland not found in your species. This is the seat of my power. I wish you to remove it, thereby making me immortal.
Jem, I'll try, but the physiology is completely alien.
You've got to do it, Bones. If the Klingons realize he's no longer a threat to them, perhaps we can avoid a war. Scotty, 5 to beam up.
Okay, then.
Captain, 3 Klingon heavy battlecruisers have just entered the system. Admiral Painter is hailing us, sir.
Federation Starship, this is Admiral Blick Painter of the Cleater. You harbor a criminal who has caused the destruction of the entire population of Rakkor. We are not prepared to negotiate. You will proceed to Rakkor, where a court of Klingon justice will be convened. If you refuse, we shall destroy you.
Admiral Blick, the criminal of whom you speak, is in the middle of a very delicate medical procedure. He cannot be handed over to anyone at this time. I cannot believe Quetzalcoatl's mission to Rakkor would cause the deaths of the entire planet. Since when do Klingons give orders to Federation officers, Admiral? I realize it's difficult for a Klingon, but don't be a fool. I cannot believe Quetzalcoatl's mission to...
His attempt to corrupt the Empire with his philosophy led to the destruction of all life on Rakkor.
How could a philosophy of peace and non-violence cause the destruction of all life on Rakkor?
Rakkor has been governed by my family for generations, but even they were corrupted by him. It was a matter of honor that his lies had to be silenced, no matter what the cost.
My God, you killed your own people just because they acquired a philosophy that you disagreed with?
Oh, snap.
So you killed them, your own family. You were responsible for their deaths, not Quetzalcoatl. You murdered them. You're insane. Tell me, how much do your commanders know about what you did? Or do you need to kill Quetzalcoatl to hide your own deeds?
I think yes.
So you killed him?
It was that creature's fault. Had he not interfered in our affairs, the people of Rakkor would be alive. Clearly he is responsible.
Message from Starfleet Command.
I'll argue this with you later, Blake.
Contact your superiors, Kirk. You may be surprised.
I have bad news, Captain. The Organians have ruled that Quetzalcoatl's interference in Klingon affairs renders him subject to Klingon law. You are to turn your prisoner over to them at Rakkor. Klingon law will permit you to observe or aid in his defense. But be very careful, Jim. Starfleet out.
Captain, you cannot turn him over to those butchers. That would be murder.
We have no choice, Scotty. I'm afraid Quetzalcoatl has a date with Klingon justice. Set course for Rakkor, Mr. Chekov.
So, yeah, now we get to see our Klingon trial.
Captain's log. We have come to the ruined Klingon planet of Fakur to deliver our guest, the mythical entity Quetzalcoatl, to a Klingon court. Dr. McCoy, Mr. Spock, and Ensign Benning and I have been granted permission by the Organians to witness this trial, which I expect to be a travesty of any meaningful definition of justice. Spock, come with me. Mr. Scott, you have the con.
The prisoner and his witnesses will stand forth, so the trial may begin. So, Kirk, we finally meet. I had thought it would be in battle, but the universe holds many surprises.
There's nothing less appealing than a gloating Klingon, Vlik. Let's get this trial underway. Stick around, Vlik. There are more surprises awaiting you. Why does every Klingon tell me they expected to meet me in battle? You really have a one-track mind. Stick around, Vlik.
So be it! This begins the trial of the entity Quetzalcoatl, who is charged with impersonating a Klingon, stirring dissent, encouraging cowardice, and treason in the highest degree.
Those are serious charges, Vlik. Should he not be tried by a Klingon High Court?
He has not demonstrated honor, Kirk. Only a proven warrior may be tried in High Court. Principles of honor are not applicable to his defense.
I'm a warrior, Vlik. I hereby intervene for him and demand the honors and responsibilities of a warrior's trial. Then this trial is a mockery for the entire galaxy to see.
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, well, I'm afraid you're on your own, Quetzalcoatl.
Yeah, that would be... Should I? Nah, I shouldn't.
Then this trial is a mockery...
How typical of the Federation to judge every other species as morally inferior. Your rhetoric is not welcome here.
I offered them insights into the philosophy of peace and cooperation. They chose to follow it of their own free will.
Quetzalcoatl, you encouraged the colony to destroy its weapons. You even encouraged them to hold their children from our traditional military ceremonies.
Children should not even play at war. To prepare them to kill is barbaric.
To counsel it is to counsel cowardice. To counsel it is to abandon all honor. This is treason for all to see. The penalty for treason in this system is death. Do you accept your sentence?
I have failed. Death is what I deserve.
He has admitted guilt. You have surrendered him to Klingon law. Can you deny that this was a fair trial?
You're going to kill this old man because he encouraged non-violence? The Federation cannot accept this. By our standards, he would rank among the greatest heroes of the Federation. Gandhi, Surak, Malal Toji, Shanarda. We will not abandon him. Guess I can't argue with you, Pleasant Conquest Admiral. By our standards, he would rank...
Pacifism is utterly alien to our people. It would be as though he preached the doctrine of suicide in direct contradiction of the will to live. Honorable men thrive in war and conflict. Cowards seek to avoid conflict.
Then a Klingon can thrive on the conflict between his inner nature and his philosophy. Clearly the people of Fra'kor did that.
Sounds right.
This is a matter for a philosophical debate, not a trial. The state has no right to interfere in a person's conscience.
That's right.
Fine. Can we get this over with? I've got shore leave scheduled on Raza next week. Then a Klingon can thrive on the conflict...
The Klingon Empire will not tolerate dissent!
Then the Klingon Empire is wrong.
Only the greatest warriors of old could say such a thing and expect to live. Do you think yourself worthy enough to walk in their footsteps?
Give me an opportunity. If I succeed, Quetzalcoatl goes free.
You know we're gonna choose death, right?
If it means that I can prevent you from murdering an ancient and blameless creature, yes. And I'm prepared to back it up.